Walking every day is one of the best things you can do for your physical and emotional health. But establishing a daily habit, that's hard. In this video, I'm going to give you 5 things that you can actually start doing today to create a daily walking habit. And in my opinion, number 5 is probably the most important. Hi, I'm Dave. It's important for you to know that I'm not a doctor, I'm not a licensed personal trainer, I'm simply a guy who loves walking. Since 2013, I've averaged about 19,000 steps every day. And for almost 3 years now, I've hosted a daily podcast, Walking is Fitness. 10 minutes long to encourage you to create and stick with a daily walking habit. And to keep it fun, I'm not in a studio saying, you should go walk now. Every episode is recorded while I'm out walking. Let's take a walk and talk about 5 things you can do starting today to create a daily walking habit. Number 1, start small. Oftentimes when we think about something new that we're going to do, a new habit we're going to create, a habit that's going to be perhaps life-changing, we're very excited and we want to start big. And of course, we've all heard the 10,000 step a day goal. That's a good goal, and it is. But it's a terrible starting goal. Instead, I recommend that you start small, 10 minutes, maybe even a 1 minute walk every day. And the value of that is creating the habit, not going so big that after that initial motivation and enthusiasm wears off, you're wondering, how in the world am I going to get 10,000 steps? Because on average, we walk about 4,000 steps a day. That's just the general back and forth walking we do from the car to the house, from the car to the store, through the store, 4,000 steps on average. To ramp up to 10,000 steps every day, you're adding about an hour of walking every day. And maybe the first couple of days when the excitement is high and the enthusiasm is strong, you can find that hour, but after a week or two, it gets really hard. Instead, I recommend start much smaller, with a 10-minute walk every day, if you're able. If not, start with a 1-minute walk. Open the door, go to the end of the driveway and back. If you live in an apartment or condo building, open the door to the end of the hallway and back. 10 minutes, it's much easier to find time for 10 minutes in your schedule than it is for 6,000 steps, which means an extra hour of walking every day. So that's number 1. Very important, start small. Number 2, find a set time in your day when you can take the walk. Look at your schedule, look at your daily routine. Is there a time every day that you can set aside 10 minutes for a walk? Now, don't forget that weekday routines tend to be a little different from weekend routines. So keep that in mind. Because if we don't have a set time, what ends up happening? The schedule gets overcrowded and we forget. We get to the end of the day and it's like, oh yeah, I was going to take that 10-minute walk. Oh, I'm too tired. I'll get to it tomorrow. That's not how you build a habit. You need to do it day after day, week after week, month after month. Find a set time in your day when you can take a 10-minute walk. So that's number 2. Number 3, make a promise to yourself. A promise that I'm going to walk every day for 10 minutes, regardless of how I feel. And set that promise for 90 days. Why 90 days? Well, on average, it takes, according to research, actually 66 days to build a new habit. So 90 days gives you a window, because some people need a little bit longer than that. Some people, not quite as long as 90 days, but 66 days is generally what we need to create a new habit. And so make a promise that every day I'm going to take a 10-minute walk, regardless of how I feel. Now, if you're sick or injured, that's different. But I'm talking about how you feel emotionally. I don't feel like it today. No, I said I was going to take a walk. I promised myself I was going to take a walk. That's important, that promise. So that's number 3. Number 4, focus on the process and not the end goal. There's a reason why you tapped play on this video. Maybe there's something that you would like to see happen in your life. Perhaps lose some weight, change an important health metric, or just feel better. The reality is, progress on these important goals takes time. And oftentimes, what happens is it takes longer than we expect. and we get discouraged. And then at some point you start wondering, why am I doing this? What is the purpose of doing this? Why am I even setting this habit? And so if you focus on the goal, discouragement can set in. Instead, focus on the process, the promise that you're going to walk every day for 10 minutes. And then every day you keep that promise, you have a win. And so day after day, taking that 10-minute walk creates daily wins. That's much more encouraging than focusing on the progress, which is going to be slow and perhaps discouraging. So that's number 4. And then number 5, and I think this is probably the most important thing, and that is find the fun. One of the reasons fitness journeys, commitments to exercise eventually fail is because it's not fun. We're looking for that progress, which is slow, so we're discouraged. It's not fun to exercise, to push ourselves physically, and what happens? We give up. One of the beautiful things about walking is that we can do other things while we're walking. We can listen to a podcast. We can listen to music. We can listen to an audiobook. You can walk with someone else and have a conversation. You can walk in an area that is beautiful. And there are so many ways to make a daily 10-minute walk enjoyable. It's important to find the fun, because even if you start with excitement and enthusiasm, at some point you're going to hit a speed bump, maybe even a roadblock. I don't feel like doing this. But if you're enjoying the walks, and there's a reason that you're looking forward to getting out and taking that 10-minute walk, again, maybe it's a podcast, maybe it's an audiobook, and each day you're listening to a different section, 10 more minutes of that audiobook, that becomes motivation to get out and take that walk. Find the fun. So those are 5 things that I think are critical to building a daily walking habit. Start small, find a set time, make a promise, focus on the process, not the goal, and then find the fun. And if you're just getting started, I want to invite you to listen to my podcast, Walking is Fitness. Every day there's a brand new 10-minute episode. And again, I'm not in a studio saying, you know what, you should go take that walk. Every episode is recorded as I'm walking outside. So essentially, we're taking a walk together. And one more thing you can do to provide a little extra encouragement, a little extra motivation, go to the website walkingisfitness.com, tap onto 90-day fitness chain tracker, it's totally free, download the tracker, it's a one sheet, there are 90 sets of footprints linked together in a chain, and every day you keep that promise to take a 10-minute walk, you can color in another set of footprints, and you're building this 90-day fitness chain. And on those days, and they will happen, on those days when you don't feel like taking the walk, you can look at that fitness chain tracker and think, you know what? I'm on day 28. I don't want to break the chain. I'm going to keep my promise. I'm going to take the walk. And so that 90-day fitness chain tracker adds a little extra motivation. I hope this helps. I hope you consider building a daily walking habit. It can change your life. Check out the podcast, Walking is Fitness. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you have a great day.